Isaiah, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord and he was high and lifted. Look at your neighbor and say, he already up there. So every time I come to church, I lift him higher, higher and higher, higher and higher. Help me lift him. Watch this. Look at the B clause. He said, Lord, I exalt you, not that you're down here, but you're already up there, so I'm just lifting you higher. Watch this. But look at the B clause. For you have, watch this, lifted me. English Standard Version said, you have drawn me. Now that's beautiful imagery for all of us children of God, because to draw something paints a beautiful picture of water being drawn from a well, which simply means, brothers and sisters, that all of us, or some of us, if not all of us, have been down to our lowest of the low of the low, but we serve a God whose hand is long enough to reach way down in the corridors of our mind and whisper in our consciousness and picks us up from the well of, and the pit of despair, and puts us up, turns us around, and places our feet on a solid ground. Look at your neighbor and say, that's why you're here, because he drew you up. That's why you're here, because he picked you up. That's why you're here, because he stood you up. And since he picked you up, since he pulled you up, since he stood you up, how about you lift him up? Do I have about 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 folk in the building who can testify? I didn't come for you. I didn't come for you. I didn't come for you. I came for him. And if I be lifted up. I'll draw all men. Look at that, look at that, look at that. What am I doing when I'm drawing? I'll draw. All I gotta do is listen. He'll draw. Lift him. He'll draw all men unto me. Look at your neighbor, so that's right there in the book. That's it. That's verse one. I will exalt because he pulled me up. I have a reason to lift him because he did most of the work. He pulled me and he did it because he loved me. You need the great spiritual. Love lifted me when nothing else would have. Love. Man, I'm trying. Some of y'all are too sleep. I mean, it's right here. The book is right here. Look at his name. Say, text talk. Watch this. He said, I'll extol him. I'll lift him. I'll raise him up. I'll exalt him because he has drawn me up. English Standard Version, you have drawn me up. And what you do, God? You have not let my foes rejoice over me. God, you lifted me so high that the enemies can't talk about me because I'm too high. Are you in here? They want to get to me, but I'm too high. They want to mess with me. Huh? But MC Hammer say, you can't touch me. They want to get to me, but I'm too high. I'm ill. Now, Lord, I'm not where you are, but you're responsible for where I am. Preach, boy. And can I put a pin mark right here and let you know that you need to quit taking credit for where you are and think about the fact that where you are, God brought you what you know. God taught you what you have. God gave you who you are. God made you. You can't put a tag on what God has done for you because the tag is too pricey. And he bought me with a price. You got gotta say amen. Just look at amen.
Watch out, preacher.
Watch this. Watch this. He said. Yes, he said, Lord, look at the Message Bible. God, my God, I yell for help, and you put me together. Huh? Verse 1, it says, you didn't let my foes gloat. Huh? When I yell for help, you put me together. Look at verse number 3. God, you pulled me out of the grave. Huh? Now watch this. When you pulled me out of the grave, look at 3, you gave me another chance at life. And you gave me another chance at life. Look at the Message. When I was down and out. Am I talking to anybody? Man, y'all, the scriptures. Am I talking to anybody in here who's ever been down and out? You didn't know which way to go. You didn't know how it was going to get fixed. You didn't know how it was going to get paid. You didn't know if you was going to get well. But God showed up and he said, wait a minute, you're still here. And you're not dead because I've already made you well. Did not I tell you that by my stripes you're already healed? Act like you're healed. Act like you're delivered. Act like you're set free. Then David gets to verse 4. David gets to verse 4. He said, listen, God been too good to me. He says, verse 4, all you saints, all you saints, sing unto the Lord. And the Message Bible says, watch this, thank him to his face. Huh? Which means I have to leave my place of comfort and convenience. Huh? To gather into the sacred space called sanctuary, because there are some things you can't get and you won't get when you're at home. Preach, boy. Some of us, you stay at home, you get more and more depressed. You stay, come on, help me in here, huh? You stay at home, all you want to do is sleep and eat, and you blame the extra weight on other folk. When it's actually the man or the woman, come on, help me in here. There's a reason why you look like. There's a reason why the suit is tight. Look at your neighbor and say, pull back from the table. You blame everything on everybody else. Boy, I got it. Am I all right, Keisha Rose? Am I preaching? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Pull away from it, huh? My mama say, well, push back a little bit, push back. Watch this. The meat of the text, the story of the text comes here. Look at verse 5. Verse 5 says, and it's strange because David starts off, you know, lifting God, praising him, magnify him, but there's a shift change. There's a picture change. There's a shift. Look at your neighbor and say shift. Yeah. Now you have to understand that you have to survive shifts in life. Yeah. And when the text shifts, you have to move with the shift. Watch this. In verse 5, he says, he gets angry once in a while. Yeah. Mm. So he don't stay angry all the time. We're going to close with that right now. So he get angry a little bit. Just a little bit. It don't last all the time. Watch this. He says, weeping, do it for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And so you have to wonder now, which the text does not tell us until verse 6. Preach, boy. Watch this. Why David wrote what he wrote? Why did he write it? David had an issue that he was dealing with because of his prosperity. Which leads me to the point. Here it is. You ready for it? Yeah. Prosperity. prosperity without humility leads to adversity. Y'all ain't gotta say amen. I said prosperity without humility leads to adversity. David's pride problem made it necessary for God to step in and chastise him. Are you in here? Sometimes God has to put a whooping on us because we're too busy whooping other folk. Oh, you missed that, huh? Can I remind it and play it? Quit whooping on other folk because other folk don't belong to you. And when you whoop other folk, God will whoop you. Look at your neighbor and say, you ain't the boss of me. Huh? And we whoop folk directly and we whoop folk indirectly. How do we whoop folk directly, Pastor Dawson? I whoop DJ. Directly. Are you in here? Huh? DJ know when daddy's upset. Huh? And when I stand up, DJ finds somewhere to get. Come on, help me in here. Huh? Look at your neighbor and say, that's direct. Indirect is when you have folk who come to church with a blade versus a Bible. Look at your neighbor and say, indirect. They ain't never got nothing good to say. They trying to run their own program. I ain't talking about nobody. Let's talk about what I'm talking about, huh? Because they think it's all about them and nothing about him. Look at your neighbor and say, baby, just work the process. God put a system in place. Work the process. Look at your neighbor and say, don't fight the process. Work the process. God gave us vision. Work the vision. God gave us a mission. Work the mission. Because it ain't about you. David had a pride problem. Job had a pride problem. Job chapter 16 verse 12 says, Job says, I was at ease. Y'all see that? I was at ease. I was cool. I was calm. I was collected. I had it going on. But watch this. He had broken me. Huh? God stepped in and he put a hurt on me. Look at your neighbor and say, why are you putting hurts on other folk? God will put a hurt on you. Be careful how you treat folk in their face and talk about them behind their back. God hears what you're saying and he knows what you're thinking before it exits your mouth. So you can't be a preacher pusher, a preacher pusher in public, and a vision killer in private. I'll wait. Watch this. Y'all, this helps everybody. See, I know some of y'all gonna leave out. Who Pastor talking about? Don't worry about it, I'm talking about me. But he has broken me. And he, watch this, he didn't stop that. He said, he has also, can I just preach this thing, y'all? He has also taken me by my neck and shaken me to pieces. Now, y'all think I'm making this up. That's Job chapter 16, verse 12. He said, not only did he break me, but he took me.